And I know that many of y'all are afraid to live holy. I know you're afraid to live right. Because you think if I live right, then I have to keep living right every day. But guess what? You can't live right one day without God's help. And if it helps you one day, he'll help you 101 days. If it helps you 2 days, he'll help you 301 days. If it helps you 5 days, he'll help you the whole time. They're trying to make the children of Israel understand something here. People are afraid because somebody said, we saw the sons of Anak, giants in the land. Says that we were in our own sights when we looked at them. We looked like grasshoppers looking up. That's how big they was. We can't beat such a big people. Joshua and Caleb told them, said the land that we went into is a good land. Being in the church, baptized in Jesus' name, with the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues, is a good thing. I don't care what nobody say. If you're going to live for God, you're going to need his spirit to do it with. If you're going to serve God, you're going to need his spirit to do it with. You can't serve God out of your own understanding. You can't perform any of his will out of the imagination of your desire. Joshua's letting them know that this land is just what God said it would be. It flows with milk and honey. It's a prosperous land. It's a beautiful land. And he said, now, listen. And listen to this vessel too. That if the Lord delighted us, earth will stop backbiting. We'll stop arguing and fussing. And we'll stop running one another down. And we'll get out of each other's business. Get on our own stuff. We might find that God will delight in us. And if God delight in us, he'll give us that that he's promised us to possess. Walk into it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Joshua told him, if the Lord delighted us, it's 2010. Yes. It's time to get God to delight. Well. It's time to quit asking God what he wants or what telling God what you want him to give you and start asking God what he wants from you. Yes. It's time to make a change in your mind about salvation unto the Lord. Time to step up and become that man, that woman that God is calling for in this last and evil day.
Right.
For the Bible said, whom he loved, he predestinated. Since we are the predestined people of God,
yes,
we need to hold our heads up,
yes,
not in pride, but in surety of our God.
Yes.
In his ability,
yes,
to deliver. In his ability to make whole. In his ability to save and sanctify and bless. Because he's the God of all life.
Yes.
Joshua telling them, if the Lord delight in us, he will bring us into this land and give it us. If God be for us. If God be for us, now if God ain't for us, we're going under.
Yes, sir.
If we don't love one another, we're going under. If we don't support one another, we're going under. If we don't quit just relying on one another, we're going under. If we don't quit signifying in one another, we're going under. But if God delight in us, I don't know about you, brother. I don't know about you, sister, but I'm going to delight time in God. I think God's going to find one vessel in the house that he can delight in. And I'm going to make sure that there's one in the house. I'm going to make it my business to become God's business so he can delight. Amen. Somebody got to stand up and start saying, I'm tired of the same old, same old. I'm tired of coming here praising God and ain't getting nowhere.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's time.
Yeah.
For of whom he foreknew. Knew you before you was you. Understood you was nasty. And you was hateful. And you was mean. Recognized the fact that saving you was going to be a hell of a job. Oh, glory. He understood that. But he took you on anyway. He didn't defer from the task at hand. I just want him to know today in 2010, I'm not going to whine no more about the saints that don't want to live right. I'm not going to pity party no more about them, the haters in the house. I'm not going to get upset about them that want to walk around with an attitude all day. I'm tired of babying and whimpering and pampering. I'm tired of changing pampers when you can get up and go to the toilet yourself. Tired of you thinking you can be the pastor of this church. Huh? Because the unfortunate part is God gave it to me. So maybe you can do better, but you can't do nothing till you get it.
That's right.
So ain't no need in you trying to tell me who should be getting used and who shouldn't. Because once you start talking like that, then I know I shouldn't be using. Oh, glory. Y'all need to understand 2010 is coming in a new way. It's time. You got to get tired every time you look up. Somebody need $5 for something.
Yes.
You don't have $2 worth of faith.
All right, Jesus.
Go hungry sometimes. Go without sometimes. And see what God will do. Because the Bible instructs us. Say, and we know, the Bible probably should say, and we should know, but it doesn't say that because the Bible know, we know.
All right now.
So it says, and we know that all things, the good, the bad, and the ugly, all things, work together. So my car broke down. Must be for a reason.
Yes, sir.
I was picking up some bricks and my back went out. Must be for a reason. Oh, my belly growled. I'm always talking about how lonely I am. So now my stomach talking to me. I don't have to be lonely no more. Must be for a reason. Because we know all things. Everything that go on, that's going on. Work together for good.
Good.
Somebody said for evil, they lie. Bible say for good. I don't see how being hungry is for my good. Think of the weight loss. I don't see how not having on the latest suit is for my good. Now you can't flirt. Oh, good. I don't see how I'm having raggedy shoes is for my good. Maybe you won't walk so much and talk so much. Oh, there's some good in everything that's going on in your life because all things work. Now we got to get to the questioning part of your youth.
Well,
to them who are the call according to his purpose.
Yes. Make it plain. Take your time,
brother. So if you ain't got nothing, that's his purpose. So if you without, lonely, that's his purpose. It don't have to make sense. But it's his purpose.
Amen.
See, I understand something about God. God don't have to make sense, because God let making sense make sense.